She loved Damon, obviously.
It'll find its way down to the sea and then anything's possible.
Damon and Debbie was great because we got to go away from the close. But we all, you know, we all went together, all the crew and the cast and everything. And it just felt like a little romantic bubble, you know, like a sort of separate story that was very fairy-tale-ish.
Come on, get me to the church on time.
My last scene in Brookside was in the dark, under Lendal Bridge in York, where we came back to the barge that we were squatting on.
It was 12 o'clock at night.
There was two lads on there burgling the place, and in a very innocuous exchange where very little was seen, they kind of just pushed past Damon, and in so doing, one of them stabbed him.
You all right?
I think so.
Come on, you can wake up. Yeah, the scallies. You want your blood sugar level going all funny again?
Damon, you're all wet. It's blood. You're covered in blood.
It was just really upsetting, you know, I got really upset and I think I just felt that it was all coming to an end.
He got internal bleeding and died there and then in the arms of Debbie.
He must have cut himself.
I think it's me.
What?
Come on, calm down. Don't want you passing out on top of everything. I'll sit down. I think he caught me with his belt or something. I feel all cold inside.
Hang on.
Oh, no, come on. It can't be anything serious. I feel all right. I'm just a bit thirsty.
I'll go and get help.
No. I don't want you wandering off on your own. They might still be around. Anyway, you've done enough running about.
He definitely took the public in because there were wreaths delivered to my real mum and dad's house. It was very strange. That mix up the people have where fact and fiction kind of blend together is very strange. The power of the soap opera is incredible.
I was walking through town with my friend and I had a red jumper on and this girl got really upset and said, how can you wear red? You should be in black. He's only just died. So I think they really captured the imagination. You know, I think people believed it.
And the nation wept. None more so than my bank manager.
You've got somewhere to go.
We've both got somewhere to go.
No, don't go.
Just to the boat, just to get...
No, we've got plans. University, the flat, the business, you said.
Damon, you're scaring me. You're talking like you're drunk. I just want to get that done.
All right. I'll just lie here. I'll just drift.
Damon, I can't understand what you're saying. Look, we've got to get you cleaned up and out of here. They might come back. I'm scared. Damon, you've got to help me. Damon? Damon? Talk to me?
Oh. Oh. She was hard-working and loving and she loved her family, but she was tough, you know.
Sheila.
I remember the producer, Stuart Doughty, was the producer then, asked me to see me and I went in and he said, we're going to have a storyline with the rape of Sheila and I wonder, he just wanted to see how I felt about doing it as an actress. I wasn't raped, but I was sexually attacked and I sort of have a great deal of understanding of how frightening that is and how appalling it then must be to be raped. So I had on that level, I was glad we were going to cover it. I thought it was great. It was great writing. And I recognised so much because when I was attacked, the first thing I did was, well, I ran in a friend's and said, I want a bath, and I had a bath. And then, of course, the police go berserk because you've washed away evidence. So you shouldn't, but you do. And what also I think was very good that you hadn't, I don't think I'd ever seen before, was the effect on a family when a rape happens inside a family. And you saw it very clearly.
What the hell's going on? For God's sake, what's going on? Sheila, what's wrong? For God's sake, Sheila, what's the matter? Where have you been? She.
So all those scenes I thought were terrific. I was very proud of it. It'll go down in sort of my history when I'm telling my grandchildren of some of the best stuff that I was proud to do.
She's a kind person, and she's been through a lot, and she's a strong person, but she's also vulnerable. My character was, she was very, very naive, had no idea what was going on. Whether she did have a sort of an idea, but had blocked out of her mind, like, oh no, I love my dad, and my dad loves us, and, you know, my mum and my sister. And, so she just kind of lived in her own little world.
What are we doing? He's brought us down to his level.
It's either him or us. When her dad actually abused her, I think, you know, she was unbelievably confused because she loved her dad so much. And I think she just blocked it out of her mind. I think she thought, well, you know, it's my fault that this happened, and, you know, my dad loves me and my mum and my sister are making all this up.
What are you doing? What are you hiding?
Go and rest.
You bloody pair of bitches!
She didn't know they'd killed him and everything, and when they told her, she hated them at first. She really disliked her mum and her sister and was just devastated that they'd done this to her dad.
Somebody should have done it years ago.
She's made you like this, hasn't she? With her lies!
No! I hate you!
Get off! I'll teach you to not have your father! You must do what you're told! I'll kill us all!
Brought it to light for everybody and just made it so that everybody could talk about it and, you know, to do something about it. Here with this, like, normal family and, you know, this little close, and it was happening to them, and you saw it from the youngest daughter's angle, the eldest daughter, the mum, and so it was brilliant that, you know, it brought it to the front for everyone to talk about. Everyone was talking about it, and everyone remembers now, you know, if they say, oh, who do you play? Oh, I'm the youngest daughter, you know, of the job. Oh, yeah, the body under the patio.